younger, we thought everyone was on our side. Then we grew a little and romanticized the time. I saw flowers in your hair. See, it takes a boy to live, it takes a man to pretend he was there. And now we demonstrated it to the cops and all the things we said. We were self-assured. So be in my eye, be in my heart, be in my eye.
Hi, I'm Chloe. Although I look like I'm 15, I'm actually 19. Don't worry, that's been a reoccurring joke of my life. When I was 15, my friends and I went out to a buffet restaurant and I got half price off because I passed as 12. It was awesome. Other than that, school's going pretty well. Something that I don't like, though, is standardized testing. You know that quote about testing a fish on its ability to climb? I think it's by Dr. Seuss or something. It's like, there's only one type of smartness that's valuable. Why can't we all be cool and smart and chill in our own way? Why is being different weird? Sorry to get all philosophical on you. Sometimes I just start and I can't really stop after that. Did you know that your phone is dirtier than a toilet? I once read about a study that showed 10 times more bacteria on the average cell phone than on a toilet. Since toilets are constantly being cleaned, but then there's your phone, which, well, you probably have never cleaned it before. Speaking about cleanliness, I danced practically my entire life. They were super strict about our buns being slicked back with gel and our tights being clean. We used to wear these sparkly costumes that we had to get measured for. I liked it, because you were excused for a bit while the rest of the class continued on with plie, sautés, and across the floor work. I often forget about my childhood. Partly because it was so long ago, and partly because I don't really want to remember it. I was often expected to do certain things and act certain ways, mostly because I was a girl. I had to stay and dance long after I got tired of it. I had to wear pink and refrain from playing guitar for the longest time, all because of my sex. I don't know. Gender roles suck, dude.
2, 1, 2, 3. In some cocktail bar when I met you, I picked you out and pulled you up and turned you around, turned you into someone new. Now 5 years later on, you got the world at your feet. Success has been so easy on you, but don't forget that I'm the one who put you where you are now. I can put you back down too. Don't you?
Oh, this day was hard. Everyone has something they're insecure about, whether it be intellect, musical talent, body type, haircut, the list goes on. And the extent is different for everyone, you know. Some days it peaks more than others. Some days we don't want to leave the house because of this one really awful haircut, and once we do muster up that energy and confidence too, one look or comment can break us down within seconds. It sucks. And that's my girlfriend. Her name's Elizabeth. She's really awesome. As you can probably tell, we like dancing and lip-singing. We do that often, honestly. We were actually going over to our friend Emily's house when we got stuck for an hour at the grocery store trying to figure out what candy to buy. We can get pretty indecisive. But we have fun adventures. It's a pretty good time. I hate when people mistake who I am. Have you ever had anyone mispronounce your name or call you by another name and you just felt off? You paused for a moment and went, "That's not who I am." Yeah, maybe the person didn't mean to offend you the first, second, or third time. But if you keep telling them and they don't have the respect to learn it or try, it feels pretty invalidating. This happens to me on a daily basis. Have you ever had to dress up for school, or go out with friends, or go on a date, and you just couldn't figure out what outfit to wear? You probably had a vision in your head. Maybe you wanted to look hardcore, or cool, or you wanted to follow the latest trend. But no matter what you put on, the gray shirt, the red shirt, the blue jacket, you just couldn't satisfy yourself. There's a lot of bliss in staying in bed, mainly to run away from the outside world, if you get what I mean. It can get exhausting living in a capitalist patriarchal society which benefits from self-doubt and time and time again tells me there's only two genders. I think I can speak for at least 99.9% of the population when I say that society has told me who I can and cannot be. Hi, I'm Cal, and I'm transgender.